odds are that your mothers, all of you, were Liz Claiborne customers. Is that true? Okay. Do we miss anybody here? Because
it was 60 years ago that I went to school here. It was shortly after World War II. I entered the school in 1948. And the focus of the school was very much on our country and how self-sufficient we were. We had the raw materials, we had the population, we had the market for the things that we could manufacture, and we were the best manufacturers in the world of almost everything.
In the old days, buyers' offices were located in the downtown department store. As a buyer, I was required to spend 50% of my time on the floor with the customers.
I loved the fashion industry, and I basically spent the rest of my career, after just a few years on Wall Street, in one aspect or another of the fashion industry. Everything from retail to some manufacturing to even running a knitting plant down south. And eventually came to work for a large specialty store chain. And so we started a European import program, and I was in charge of it. And frankly, I had never been to Europe, and made my first trip there in the late 50s. And then I would make two or three trips a year. And I made my first trip to the Far East in 1959. I went to Japan. Japan was still living in the throes of losing World War II, and then made my first trip to Hong Kong.
We came into the business in 1976. The main mode of dress was, in fact, a dress. That's what women wore. I felt that women were ready for a change, and in fact, they were.
When we founded Liz Claiborne, we became a rather rapid success. It was obvious that we could not find sufficient factory space in this country to make all of the garments we needed at the price and quality level that we had established our company to be. And I suggested to the company that we should consider having goods made overseas. And I thought Liz would have a heart attack. And she said, we can't manage factories that we have in New Jersey. And here you want to make stuff 10,000 miles away? He said, never, never. And we gave him a very kind of a difficult blouse to make that we were having a very tough time getting made in this country. And the merchandise came back from Hong Kong and it was beautiful. She couldn't believe it. And much cheaper than we could have made it in this country. And so that was the beginning. And within a year, we were 100% overseas. And I used to think to myself that if I had not had that experience and background as a retailer in going overseas and so on, Liz Claiborne would have been another small mom and pop business. Never got any place.
Liz was a true designer. She was very concerned about fit. Liz wore pants every day. Our pants became very popular, and that was something that helped us a lot in future years as we expanded the company and went into other categories. So we broke all the rules.
Many, many years later, I guess it goes all the way to 1990, which is 40 years after I graduated, I was approached by the dean at the time, Mayor Felberg, and I said, you know, every student that graduates from the Columbia Business School should understand the importance of international trade and the fact that this is a global economy. Things were much different in 1990 than they even are today. And some of the things that I talk about are, of course, everybody knows that, you know. But in 1990, not everybody knew that. We came up with the idea of starting an international institute of business.
My name is Xiang Jingwei. I'm the director of Columbia Business School's Chazen Institute of International Business. Our honor speaker tonight is Vice Minister Liu Sijin.
And he would take all the courses that were being offered and sort of wrap them around this institute. And then we would figure out other things that the institute could do. One of them, which has become the most popular part of the Institute are arranging overseas trips for students, where they're accompanied by professors. They get a background in seeing business practices in other countries. So I'm very pleased about that, and I'm very pleased about what it's accomplished in the school. We also have language study programs for the kids and so on and so forth, understanding that today if you want to work in a foreign country, you better speak the language. And we're moving in a direction of trying to establish the Institute as sort of a think tank for problems that are international in scope, that we could, we at Columbia, not only within the business school, but within all of the areas of expertise that we have as a university, could help coming up with potential solutions to problems and giving professors and others an opportunity to work on things of that nature. We have a whole system now of planning cases for international companies to be taught in the business school by different professors. The education that I had gotten at the business school was very helpful to me in my business career. I understood what big business was all about, and I wasn't afraid to move in directions that would make our company big. And we were a little startup company at Liz Claiborne. I mean, we started with zero volume, with a total investment of $250,000. And within 10 years, we were doing $4 billion worth of business. It was an incredible kind of run. There were fundamental management techniques that I had first learned about at Columbia, and of course picked up on in all my years before we started Liz Claiborne, but that were very helpful in building the company.
There's a couple of mantras, let me mention before I quit, that I think are very important to get across. The first one is, know your customer. And that means really know your customer. Talk to your customer. Spend time with your customer. I don't care if you're selling software or if you're selling apparel. Doesn't matter. The second mantra is, let your overhead follow your sales. I don't care what company you work for, where you go, how big it is or how small it is. It works every time. So both of those things, know your customer, let overhead follow sales, and I guarantee you success.